Literary genius Bibhuti Bhushan's beloved Ichhamati forms the border of India and Bangladesh. On one side is the huge Parmadan forest and on the other, an ancient Neelkoti. Adjacent to the Koti is a small village called Mangalganj, where humans apparently coexist with ghosts.
মানুষ ভূতের সাথে মঙ্গলগঞ্জে থাকতে থাকতে এখন পুরো অভ্যস্ত হয়ে গেছে।
তাহলে আমি 17 বছর বয়স থেকেই ভূত পেট দেখতে দেখতে আমার একটা হেভি অবস্থা হয়ে গেছে, আমি ভয় পাই না।
Even I am not afraid. But this Kata Sahib's Kuti is visited by ghost seekers from across the country. Many supernatural stories have been heard about this place. Are the stories real? Come find the truth with me. I am Ron and you are watching The Mystery of Mangalganj. History states that it was through Zamindar Mongol Chandra Ansha's help that the British entered the village. They forced the farmers to grow indigo, which met the farmers' protest, leading to their torment. Okay. The riot started in Mangalganj when the British exploited the local women.
গ্রাম থেকে মহিলাদেরকে তুলে আনা হতো, বাইজি বাড়িতে বাইজি নাচ করানো
হতো। ওকে,
এবং তাদের সু
ইউ মিন উইমেন ওয়ার গেটিং টর্চার্ড। দ্য ব্রিটিশ স্টার্টেড কিপিং দেয়ার প্রিজনার্স ইন আন্ডারগ্রাউন্ড চেম্বার্স, বাট স্টিল when the farmers didn't comply, the Britishers started killing them one by one.
যে কত মানুষকে আটকে রাখা হয়েছে, তিনেরা বললো 100 কি 150, তার থেকে 50টা মানুষকে মেরে দাও, মেরে দিয়ে ভয় দেখাও যে নীল চাষ না করলে সমস্ত গ্রামবাসীকে নিয়ে এসে একটা একটা করে মারা হবে।
During this time in Bengal, the freedom movement had just begun. The fire against the British government was starting to spread through the nation. Now the farmers were losing their patience too.
সমস্ত পরগনার চাষিরা এককভাবে এই সাহেবদের উপরে ঝাঁপিয়ে পড়ল। সাহেবরা কি করলো, আর তো বাঁচার উপায় নাই, তখন কিছু সাহেব সুড়ঙ্গ দিয়ে নদী পথে পালিয়ে গেল।
Few of them escaped, but the farmers managed to capture the main officer who had implemented the tortures.
ওই যে নিচে আটকে রাখা হয়েছে তার মধ্যে এক সাহেবকে গলা কেটে দেওয়া।
Since then, the mansion is known as Kata Sahib's Kuti. Till today, his ghost can be seen after sundown. With him returns many more phantoms. But what really happens in Mangalganj after the sun goes down?
রাত্রের পরে বা সন্ধ্যার পরে পরিবেশটা এতই নিঝুম যে একটা জলের ফোঁটা যখন পড়ে সেই শব্দটাও কানে যায়। তো ভূতে যদি জ্বালাতন করে সেটা তো মানুষ ভয় পাবেই না।
যে আমি দেখি কালো মতো কি একটা যেন আমার সামনে দিয়ে চলে গেল।
একজন মহিলা প্রায় মাঝে মাঝে দেখা যায় ইছামতি নদীতে চান করছে, ঘড়াই করে জল আনছে, মন্দিরে জল ঢেলে শিবকে পুজো করে এই জঙ্গলটায় চলে আসছে।
সে কি দেখেছে, দেখেছে আস্তে আস্তে সেই নদীর ধারের দিকে এসেছে, এসে ওকে দেখা যাচ্ছে মাথা নিচের দিকে দিয়ে পা উপর দিকে।
মানে মানুষটা কে, এত লম্বা মহিলা আমাদের গ্রামে তো কেউ নেই।
ওকে,
2 সপ্তাহ আগেও এক মহিলা বাসছে।
ওকে,
মানে এইভাবে 1 মাস 2 মাস অন্তর কেউ না কেউ শিশেদ কর।
ওকে, while some believe in ghosts, others rubbish it.
তুমি দেখেছো ভূত কোনদিন?
এরা কি অশিক্ষিত লোক নাকি যে ভূতের ব্যাপারে কিছু বিশ্বাস করে?
চোখে দেখতে হবে তারপর তো বলা যাবে এটা তো একটা ভূত।
এটাকে আস্তে আস্তে গ্রামের লোক বিভিন্ন টুরিস্টদের মানে আকর্ষণ পাওয়ার জন্য আর কি, আকর্ষিত করার জন্য এটাকে এই ভূত ভূতুরে বাড়ি হ্যান্তা।
Still, when the night comes, no one would go towards the mansion. Have you ever gone out in the evening alone?
No, no.
So you finish your walk during daylight?
দিনের বেলা থাকতে থাকতে হয়ে যায়।
না, আমরা তো সন্ধ্যা হলে আসি নদী।
সন্ধ্যের পর মানুষজন এই চত্বরে কি পরের যে গ্রামটা আছে মানে সন্ধ্যের পর আর কি যারা বাড়ি ফেরে তারা 7 কিলোমিটার ঘুরে অন্য রাস্তা দিয়ে বাড়ি ফেরে, কিন্তু এই রাস্তাটা ইউজ করে না তারা।
What is the truth exactly? Is something really haunting Mangalganj? We'll find that out. But first, in this beautiful twilight, let us listen to a folk song.
কুল ভাঙ্গে ও কুল গড়ে এই না নদীর খেলা, সকাল বেলায় আমি যে ভাই ফকির সন্ধ্যা বেলা।
At the end of the day, life is indeed like a river. We need to keep flowing.
কোথায় রে তুই হারিয়েছিলি, ওরে বিভুল ঘুমিয়েছিলি। করলো বুঝিনি রে তুই পারে যাবার বেলা এই তো নদীর খেলা একুল ভাঙে ও কুল গড়ে এই না নদীর খেলা
So, as we have seen from the morning, different people have experienced this phenomenon. And tonight, hopefully, we shall too. Thank you for the amazing hospitality and for the great dinner. Almost midnight. So, let us proceed with the investigations. Good night. I'll see you in the morning. We have been shooting since morning. I need to tell you guys that since we left Kolkata, we are facing problems after problems after problems. But we have managed through the hurdles just to bring the truth to you. I would appreciate your support. Kindly like this video, comment and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to click the bell icon so that you get the notifications as soon as we post the videos. You're watching Seekers of Souls Season 2 Episode 1 with Vijay Ron and... We sat in the car for an hour. We have been waiting here for over an hour now, but couldn't do a thing because it was raining so heavily. Things have been problematic since the start today. But fortunately, the rain has stopped, and now we will go inside and we'll investigate the entire night. We will carry out the investigation in two rooms. In one room, we'll set this motion sensor light. So, we'll set up the motion sensor in this room. And we have already set the camera above. And here on the ground, I'll keep down the motion sensor. It's an automatic device. Since I'm here, this will stay on for a while. And then it will get switched off by its own. And until and unless something passes over it, this light will remain switched off. I'm going to keep the camera rolling here and head over to the other room to do the next set of investigations. Till then, you guys keep your eyes on this device. Let's see if we can catch something on this camera. In the next room, we'll try to call out the spirits with our other devices. What are these devices? I'll explain eventually. But right now, let's head in. And obviously, we won't have the car headlights inside, so I'll have to rely on my torch. This, in fact, is my primary light source. So let's head inside. Come, follow me. Come, let's go. I am just checking the roof once because there could be several kinds of other trouble here. There is a possibility of bats, even snakes on the ground. And since it has rained today, there is a chance of leeches as well. So pretty damn scary, even without spirits. The roof seems to be all clear as of now. Come, follow me. But watch your steps carefully. See this side? The left side of the mansion is covered in dense forest. And this jungle is a popular suicide point, as we got to know from the locals. So, let's take a look around and then we'll do the setup. As of now, we are at least safe from the snakes and the bats, and I really hope it remains that way. Come, still bro, watch your steps carefully.
Yes,
because you never know, you're in the middle of a jungle. And so anything can happen. Do you see where this straight path leads? That is the tunnel. There must have been a way to go down there. Oh, it's all broken now. The tunnel is closed. The place is completely in the ruins. And we might try to find a way inside. If there is a possibility, that is. Till the time we were inspecting the place, the recording of this camera clearly shows that there is nothing. ওকে, সো টাইম ফর সেট আপ, লেট আস টেক ওয়ান ফাইনাল লুক অ্যাট দ্য গ্রাউন্ড। হেই, ডু চেক ইউর ফিট, লুকস গুড, কুল। নাও লেটস টেক আউট মাই গ্যাজেটস ওয়ান বাই ওয়ান ফ্রম দ্য ব্যাকপ্যাক অ্যান্ড লেটস সেটল ডাউন। আই থিঙ্ক ইট উড বি বেস্ট টু সেট ডাউন অন দ্য ফ্লোর অ্যান্ড ডু দি ইনভেস্টিগেশন। সো কাম, লেটস এম্পটি দ্য ব্যাগ অ্যান্ড হেড অ্যালং ইন টু দ্য ইনভেস্টিগেশন রাইট অ্যাওয়ে।
কুল, লেট মি সেট দ্য ক্যামেরা অ্যাজ ওয়েল।
ইয়েস, ইউ অলসো গেট রেডি, লেটস বিগিন। So, I have settled down and all my devices are now out and it's time to get the investigation up. The procedure is simple. Investigation will involve the gadgets. I'll explain the gadgets one by one as we proceed. The main job of this voice recorder is to record those voices that we cannot hear normally, including spirits answering our call. Basically, frequencies that we cannot hear with our ears gets recorded in this, and that is the area that this gadget covers. Throughout the session, as long as we investigate, the recorder will stay on. So in case the replies come, we will be able to hear them later. I'm going to press the record button and keep it down here. And now it's time for the K2 meter or the EMF meter, and it detects the electromagnetic field of a place. So when it stays normal as it is now, you can see a single green light denoting it's normal. So it's basically mean that there is no presence of magnetic field anywhere near. And since we are in a deserted building in a village, there is no magnetic field around anyway. I'll start calling out and check if the readings increase. It starts with green, then yellow, and finally red. The extreme scale is red. What was that? Okay, back to normal. But I just saw a fluctuation. This is our main gadget, and a lot of experts use this to check anomaly. The process of using this is to switch it on and then start calling. If there is anyone here, kindly please contact with us. I'm Ron, and I want to establish a connection with you. If there is any presence around, please, please give me a signal so that I can understand you're here, so that I can talk with you. Initially, seeing that nothing was happening, I thought it was a fluke after all. But then things got worse. Please show this on camera. Yes, give me signals. Please give me more signs. If you are here, please let me know. If you are here, give us a strong yellow signal. Can you hear me? If you're here, please give me a signal. Show the yellow light. Dude, you got the blinks on camera, right?
Yep.
Strong yellow readings as of now. We'll keep this on and let's proceed to the others. This is copper pendulum. I'm keeping my arm still. If there is any presence around, this should move to and fro. Nothing yet. I haven't felt a thing yet.
Even my K2 meter has gone green, no signals.
The EMF was giving signals from the right side, a bit more. So...
You know what is on the right side?
I don't know. The jungle, I guess.
It's the jungle. The local suicide point.
Fine. Let's move on.
This is, of course, is the compass, and it helps to determine our positions properly. I'll hold it still and position it towards north. I wish we could get a close-up for this. In case I see any anomaly, I'll tell you to come here and get a shot of this compass. I'll try calling out again. Hey, did you just feel something? Of course we did. A sudden cold air, a small sound, and a rotten smell. But we were not getting enough substantial evidence on camera. Our devices weren't giving enough readings. Tease at that point, my DOP suggested we move a little towards the jungle.
Bro, I think you should move towards the right.
Okay.
Since the little signals we got all came from that side.
Okay.
Whatever little you can access.
So I'm taking the EMF along with me. Are you trying to contact with us?
Red. It's red.
It's red. It's definitely red. Pass me the sound recorder. And this was the first time on our EMF meter did we see the full readings, and that led us to believe that whatever must have happened here at this spot. And guess where it was? The entry to the secret tunnel which led to the harem and escape route. There's definitely a reading here. Finally, we have readings. Let's start the questions, huh? Let's go up a bit. Hey, be a bit careful. Step with caution. Oh, okay. Please give me a signal if you're here. Please establish contact with me. I am not here to disturb you. Please give us a signal. Okay, let's see this side. Signal. The readings here are clear and for all to see. I really have no explanations. It is crystal clear.
Can we spot the exact location?
This is the exact location.
Shift a bit towards the right.
This is the exact location. The location where we are getting absolute red in. This is it, the spot. Let us try to enter this place. There's nothing inside, it's dead end. The dead end to the tunnels from all the stories. The way that probably leads to hell that is now closed forever.
In the middle of a jungle? A scientific gadget which didn't work anywhere else but goes bonkers exactly here. This probably is a strong proof that we have just recorded, and I generally don't disbelieve what I see, and you just saw it too. It's in the camera and it's getting recorded.
We were getting strong readings, and as you have must guessed, I was starting to fall ill. I had previously seen a lot of paranormal investigators fall sick when they encounter evil spirits. We didn't know what was there.
हम बात करना चाहते हैं आपसे.
Or who was there?
so we tried different languages.
If someone is here, please let us know.
To establish a connection.
We want to talk with you.
And get to communicate with whatever was present.
So let us move and check out the other devices. Because they'll help us to reach a conclusion. Okay, so we have covered some gadgets and we'll continue with the rest. Like this one that I just set up here. As you can see the wall behind me, these are all laser rays. If any entity passes through this grid, it will cast an image and the rays will get dispersed. The camera is ready to capture whatever we miss in our naked eyes. This setup is done. The laser grid will remain static with the camera behind. And now let's move on to the last two devices to check if we can get anything from this device. I'll repeat this again. The EMF and other devices has given us some readings, some evidence, definitely. Let's see what this one does. I'll hold my hand straight to see if there is any reading. The only way to do it is to keep it straight. I tried giving it a support, but it has to held straight if we want to perform it correctly, absolutely straight like this. Give us a signal. Damn, it's happening. It's getting crossed and I'm not doing a thing. I'm getting a strong feeling, guys. I have to measure the temperature around. I'm getting a really strong feeling. I do not joke about these things, and I'm certainly not joking right now. It's a full cross now. Let me check with the thermometer once. This is an infrared thermometer. We mostly know this device. We use it to measure temperature. So now I have to hold it and scan it. So now what I'm going to do is...
This one blinked.
I'll hold this still and I'm going to check the meter readings of the jungle. I hope the camera is getting this.
It is 3.3. 0.2.
In paranormal investigations, what happens most of the time is that if there is any presence around, how does the infrared thermometer detect it? The temperature falls if there is any presence. That's what usually happens, and that's what we are checking in this section.
Give it a second. It takes a while to get the reading.
Oh my god. Do you see the dip? If we take 81 to be the final reading, let us just go out. Keep rolling, you're rolling, right?
Yep, let's go.
You're rolling, right? I'll just take a reading somewhere near to see what the reading comes. Ideally, the temperature should not fluctuate. Okay, so just outside the room where it's relatively open, we can see a reading of 81.6. 0.8, 0.9, 82. It's increasing continuously to 81.9 or it's 82. It's still going up, where inside it should have been warmer. There we got lower readings. Because of the lanterns, the temperature should be warmer inside. But on the contrary, it's warmer outside. But the place where the EMF blinked and the dowsing rod crossed, where it got goosebumps, and there the temperature was cooler. And
all the gadgets we wanted to cover. We have covered them on camera. And now what we'll do is that it's already getting late. We'll see the recordings in the post and get the details understanding.
Understood. And what I understood is that there is something in Mangalganj. Some strong signals, a bit of disappointment, a lot of goosebumps conclude a journey. The rest I'll leave for you to decode. Do comment and let us know what you think about this episode and where next would you want to see Team Seekers of Soul. That's it for now. This is your host Ron signing off. Stay blessed and face your fears.